Okay, so today we're going to have a look at assembling this audio kit. This kit is based on the LM386 audio amplifier, which is around about half a watt audio amplification. Can be adjusted up to, I believe, about 40 dB gain. So what we'll look at, we'll have a look, quick look at the quick kit. And we'll have a look at the data sheet. So we'll go through and assemble this board. Get the components out. Here we've got some capacitors, electrolytics, audio input jack, couple of pots, couple of resistors. You can just check their ohmage. Board says they're 10 ohm. Set the meter to auto. There we go, 10 ohms. Meter was set to manual. 10 ohms, just as the kit says. We'll just check the pots. So the checker, potentiometers, ohms value. Just go to the two outside legs. Ten K. We can quickly check the capacitors. Switch our meter over to capacitance. Four, 4.6 nanofarads, close to the 47 nanofarads that we require. One's a bit higher at 50. Keep my fingers out of the job. This here is a 10 nanofarad. Microfarad. Hundred microfarad. Ten microfarad, those two together, 200 mics together. 100 nanofarads. It's a quick check of all the components that have got to go into this circuit. So 100 nanos. So all the components are operational and working. They're new, so they should be. Got our board there. What I'll do before we go to the data sheet is what I'm going to do is, I've got a second board. I'm going to tape these two boards together. And when we put the components through, we're then going to flip the board. And when we cut them off and remove the bottom board, all our component legs will be at the same length. So we'll go through that. We'll have a quick look at the data sheet. The LM386 and then get to assembling.
So we're just going to have a quick look at the data sheet. I said before that I thought the amplifier went to 40 dB, but it says here clearly in the data sheet that the gain is set to 200 dB, so 20 and 200. There's the pinouts there. Operating voltage is up to 15 volts max. We are going to run it at 4 for testing. It says here 12 max. The output gains here. So I'll just show you pins. Have a look at the schematic here that we're using. The differences are we're using a 100 microfarad capacitor here. It there, the gain of 200, and we'll test it like this with pins 1 and 8. No capacitance between 1 and 8 bypassing that the resistor. So we'll just have a quick squeeze here and have a look at how you do the gain control. To make the LM386 a more versatile amplifier, two pins 1 and 8 are provided for gain control. With pins 1 and 8 open, the 1.35 kilo-ohm resistor, the internal resistor, sets the gain to 20, which is a 26 dB gain. If a capacitor is put from pin 1 to 8 bypassing the 1.35 k-ohm resistor, the gain is set to that figure there, 200. So we'll run over both of them. I'll link this data sheet in for your perusal down below, and we'll head off and get to assemble this board.
Right, let's get to and assemble this kit. So we will start by taping the two boards together. Let's find the roll of the edge of the tape. There we are. Good day. So, when you're taping these boards together, you want to try and get them exactly lined up perfectly so all the holes line up. And we may just put some on the other side as well. Okay, so our boards taped together. thing I like to do when I'm assembling boards is pop a little bit of super glue on them, so when you flip the board on certain components so they don't fall out, and other components I'll drop a bit of solder on a pin to hold them in while we trim the legs. So we'll start by placing the capacitors. Just get a little bit of glue, put a small dot on each. You only want a small bit, you don't want to get it on the pads. Each capacitor. Just to hold them while we trim the leads. So we'll put our 200 nanofarads in, 100 microfarads, sorry. Long leg is the positive side, make sure you get the negative sides correct. Just bring the second set of hands on the job.
So the 10 microfarads are our gain control capacitors, setting the board to gain of 200. So they're the ones we'll be removing later on. So the wind, just push them down, make sure they're sitting on that glue, and we'll wait for them to dry. Next we'll place the resistors. The RCs. Make sure that you observe the polarity of all your components. The polarized, so the RCs must face a certain direction. Two ceramic capacitors. Okay, we'll place these connectors after. They don't need trimming off those leads, so we'll place them afterwards. So we'll just get the soldering iron now. And solder a few of those components down so we can flip the board. Now you don't want to apply too much solder so it goes through to the second board, and then you can't get them apart. We'll just apply a little bit of solder. Take this apart now. Tape off. Remove that bottom board. And you'll see all our pins are at the same length. Okay, ready for soldering. So we will attempt to swap over to the microscope for doing the soldering so we can see that. Put it a little closer. Oh, we've got the cap. So I'll just pop a bit more glue on that capacitor. And close it. Okay. Let me flip the board.
So we're just going to test this unit now, this audio board. So we've got the power and ground connected and we'll feed in 4 volts. We've got the speaker connected here and we've got audio coming from the computer. So just adjust the audio volume on the computer to the lowest setting. Then we'll turn the unit on. It's working. And we'll slowly increase the audio volume of the computer. A little bit of distortion coming into that now, so just adjust the pot. Oh, wrong side. Okay, we'll feed a bit more input signal in. 50%, 60, 70, 100. Just adjust that back. Bit of distortion, so we'll turn it back. Okay, so that's the right hand side channel calibrated. Ooh, we'll do the left hand channel. Switch the power off. Okay, power on. Oh, bit of an oscillation. Okay. So we just adjusted the volume until that oscillation went away. We're at 50% there, so we'll just wait for another song to come on. I believe we have to adjust this down. Okay, so let's take it up to 100%. There. Okay, so there's a good little circuit that you can run off USB power, so that's at 4 volts. We'll just turn it up to 5 volts. So that's at 5 volts there. So a good little circuit you can run off USB power, a couple of communication speakers. Use it as computer speakers. cheap, easy way to get a set of external computer speakers. Probably not the highest quality, but not too bad. Okay, thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe.
So, now that you've liked and subscribed, I did promise early on that we would test this at the lowest gain. So, I've got a speaker wire come loose here, we'll just fix that. I've gone ahead and removed the 10 mic capacitors that are doing the gain control. And we're just back to the internal 1.3K, 1.36 I think it is K resistor, the IC. So, let's power back up. See what's changed. Got a bit of static there, so let's adjust the volume. So just by adjusting the volume hot there, we've got the speaker running on very little gain. The 20. We'll turn the speakers back up of the computer. Nope, they're at 100%. So if you wanted to lower the component count of your project, just by leaving out that capacitor, you get a fairly decent gain from the IC. Okay, once again, if you haven't already, like and subscribe. I'll keep working on more videos, and hope you enjoyed. Thank you.